Hi everybody, it's Gary from Ultibo.org and welcome to the Discovering Ultibo series. This is episode one. We're going to do Getting Started today. I know there's a lot of you who've probably looked at what we're doing and perhaps don't quite see how easy it is to get started. So we're going to actually run through the Hello World example from start to finish, including installing Lazarus and getting everything up and running. And we'll run it on our Raspberry Pi, see how easy it really is to do. Right here I've got a Raspberry Pi 2 connected to HDMI and power. It's got the SD card in it running the Ultibo demo, which you've all seen. So that's ready for when we compile our first project. So we'll move over to the computer and we'll get started on installing Ultibo Core. So we'll bring up Firefox, do the Ultibo homepage, go to Downloads, click on the Ultibo Core link, choose where to save it to. C Downloads is good. We'll just see how long that's going to take. And that's not taking very long at all. We can just wait a few seconds and that will be complete. So our download's finished. We can close that and we can put Firefox away. We'll go to C Downloads. Close that. And we'll double click the Ultibo Core installer. Click on the run message. Click yes to the security warning. I'll select English. Choose the path to install into. You can change the path to anything you'd like, but be aware that you can't have a space in the name. That's just a limitation of Free Pascal Compiler. So we'll go next and we'll answer the questions. Click install. So while that's installing, I'll just say if any of you have already got Free Pascal or Lazarus installed, there's no problem with installing Ultibo Core alongside. It installs into a different path and keeps its settings in a different path as well. So they won't conflict. You can have the two quite happily coexist together. So that could be helpful if you're already a developer with Lazarus and Free Pascal. So we'll just wait for that to finish. So our installation is complete there. We'll click on finish, get rid of the download folder. We'll go to the start menu. All programs, Ultibo Core, and we choose the Lazarus IDE Ultibo Edition. Because this is the first run, we get prompted with a little Welcome to Lazarus window. It will highlight anything in red that's got a problem. If there's nothing highlighted in red, then we're right to go. We can click Start IDE and off we go. Now, first time up, it will open us a blank project. Just as a quick run through the menus for those not familiar with Lazarus, File menu has all your standard file, open, close, save commands, Edit for cut, copy, paste and all that sort of thing, Search for finding things in files, View for switching between the different Lazarus windows, bringing up different windows, Source has lots of functions for inserting comments in your source and code completion, etc. The project menu for new project and open and save project. Run for compile and build. The tools menu for lots of tools. Window and help. So right now we'll go back to the project menu and we'll go new project. Because I have a Raspberry Pi 2, I'll select new Raspberry Pi 2 application, go OK. It leaves me with a blank project window. I'll just expand that out a little. And we've already got some pre-filled in units that it includes by default. We're going to add, so this is Hello World, we want to print on the console, so we're going to add the console unit, because that would be helpful. Now, we need a variable for a handle, because we're going to create a console window. just a normal T handle, and then we can start putting our program code in. So our first line is to create a console window. So we go console window create, and Lazarus will prompt us with what parameters are required. We need a console device. So simplest way, since there's only one, we can go console device get default. It wants a position. I know that we want to do the full screen, so we'll go console position full, and it asks us, do we want this to be the default window? Well, it'll be the only window, so true would be fine. Now we need to go back to the start of the line and save the return from that to our handle. So that gives us a console window. We can go console window right line. We need a handle. We just created one of those, so we put that in, and we need some text. So let's go hello Ultibo. Close that off. For safety, I always like to put down the bottom here, thread halt, exit code 0, just to stop our main thread from exiting. So that's our program, hello world. We go to the project menu, save project, and I'll save it to C drive discovering, and I'll create a new folder called 01 getting started, and we'll call our project getting started. Click save. Alright, we've saved our project. We can click run compile, and we get the messages window with any errors or messages, and if we get a green bar that says success, then we are done. We can take the output of that, which will go to C drive discovering getting started, and there's our kernel7.img. I'll bring up my SD card, which in this case is W, and I'll get rid of what's in there. We need our kernel7.img. We also need a couple of other files, the firmware for the Raspberry Pi. So if we go back to where Ultibo was installed, core firmware, Raspberry Pi 2, we need bootcode.bin, fixup.dat, start.elf, copy those, paste them on our SD card. We can now eject that and try it in our Raspberry Pi. So let's go back to the Pi. Okay, so we've got our SD card with our kernel image for our Hello World copied onto it. We take that and we plug it into our Raspberry Pi. Very tiny little thing. And then we take the power out, count to 2, and plug it back in. If I can find the socket. And we have Hello Ultibo. So it's as simple as that. Getting started is really easy with Ultibo. You don't need to spend hours and hours just working out how to get started. You just download it, install it, start writing your code. Come back and join us again. We're going to do more of this series. We're going to cover all sorts of topics. So I hope this has inspired you to have a go and try it out for yourself. Thanks for joining us. See you next time.